with India's demographics and industrial might, complementing U.S. technological entrepreneurism. The Indo-U.S. relationship now, as we all have heard, has evolved into a strategic partnership of global significance. President Biden and Prime Minister Modi have rightly framed this relationship as a global partnership for good. We at General Atomics are strongly partnered with India on national security initiatives with support from the United States government and look forward to long-term engagement to help support India's defense and energy requirements. We believe that the U.S.-India cooperation should also include joint development and commercialization of next-generation nuclear energy systems. Nuclear energy, undisputedly, is the most robust source of clean, continuous power, and achieving dramatic reductions in generation costs, increasing safety, and minimizing proliferation risks. Supplementing the U.S. technological innovation with the manufacturing expertise of India would provide, in my view, high-quality construction of advanced reactors and associated fuel facilities at potentially much lower costs. General Atomics is also the world's most prominent and largest private industry participant in the development of fusion energy systems. The D3D National Facility, owned by the U.S. Department of Energy and operated by us in San Diego, is the focal point of the U.S. fusion program. As both countries envision fusion playing a central role in meeting their long-term energy independence and climate goals, I think jointly developing a net electric fusion reactor with India under a cooperative scientific, technical, and manufacturing program should definitely be explored. The US and Indian public and private sectors working together would intensify and accelerate the progress in ensuring that both our nations have the latest, best, and most cost-effective nuclear technologies at our disposal. Today, we are joined by the Honorable Secretary of the United States Department of Energy, Jennifer Granholm, over a video message. Secretary Granholm was sworn in as the 16th Secretary of Energy on February 25th, 2021. The Honorable Secretary has previously led the state of Michigan, as many of you know, as its governor from 2003 to 2011. Secretary Granholm was also elected as a Attorney General of Michigan and served as the state's top law enforcement officer from 1998 to 2002. After two terms as governor, she joined the faculty of the University of California, Berkeley as a distinguished professor of practice in the Goldman School of Public Policy. Focusing on the intersection of law, clean energy, manufacturing, policy, and industry, she is an honors graduate of both the University of California, Berkeley, and Harvard Law School. I invite all of you to